I kind of really like Meshgrid. It's a little awkward and strange and insert obvious statement here about awkward and strange. So say I want to buy stuff and I want to buy stuff and I'm not sure. I might want to buy four things, or I might want to buy seven things, or I might want to buy 10 things. I'm not sure. And the price of stuff at some various locations I've kind of shopped around, so I can either buy stuff $12, or I can buy stuff for $15. That's not $15, that's okay. Or $18, or $20, or $54. Okay, so that obviously is kind of an expensive place for stuff. But anyway, for some reason, I can buy stuff at all these different prices. So basically, what I want to know are what are all the price combos, total prices. What you doing? So, basically, what I want to know is what are all the different combinations. So I could buy, basically what I want to know is, okay, I could buy four at 12. So my goal, I'm going to put my goal, what I want to know is I want to know, okay, four times 12 is 48, and then four times 16 is some, bigger number that ends in a four, I think. Maybe 68? I don't know. This is why I don't do math in my head. I program it. But you see what I'm saying? Like, I want to multiply 4 by 12, and then 4 by 16, and 4 by 18, and 4 by 20, and 4 by 54. And then I want to multiply, like, 7 times 12, and 16, 18, 15, and 4. And then 10 times all these numbers. So there's really not a way to do this in MATLAB, because I can't just, like, multiply this, because they are a 1 by 3 and a 1 by 5, and it's going to yell at me for dimensions. I'm still gonna yell at me. I can't do element by element matrix multiplication because, again, they're not the same size. I'm not buying the same number of stuff as I have prices of stuff. And even if I did, it would just multiply. Even if I'm like, oh, I'll fix the problem, I'll just pretend that I want zeros. But then all it's gonna do is multiply 4 by 12, 7 by 16, 10 by 18, and then 0 times 20 and 0 times 54. That's not what I want. I actually want every combination of one to the other. So basically, there's this really kind of a cool thing called Meshgrid. So I'm going to make, it doesn't matter what I call it, but this, whatever you call it, thingy, this function actually has two outputs. So the only way to get two outputs out of something is to ask for both of the outputs. So I'm going to call it my buy grid and my price grid and mesh grid. I don't have to call them grid. It just makes more sense to me. So this is really amazing. So I want you to see what this did. Okay, you can't see it and what it did at the same time. We'll make this together. All right. So I have buy grid and I have price grid. So look at what they did. So buy stuff was 4, 7, and 10. Price of stuff was 5 elements long. So look what it did is it took buy stuff and it made 4, 7, 10 5 times. And then it took price grid, it did the transpose of it and made it 3 times. But basically what it did is it manipulated these two matrices until I got something where they both are the same size. So see, now if I multiply these two matrices by each other, I don't, I'm gonna, if I type it, it'll go away, you won't see it. But now if I do an element by element multiplication, I can get 4 times 12, 4 times 16, 4 times 18, and 4 times 20. So I'm gonna copy these over to my little notepad, maybe. So now that I have these kind of like this, if I do an element by element multiplication, it's going to multiply this guy by this guy. And it'll multiply this guy by this guy. And I'll do this guy by this guy. Because this is element by element, right? That was the whole point. And this guy by this guy. So that's assuming I do the dot multiply. So if I do the dot multiply, that's what it's going to do. So what Meshgrid is going to do is it's going to basically manipulate those two matrices. So the first one gets to stay as a row, the second one moves to the column organization, and the reason is that now whenever I do a dot multiply between the two of them, that in fact will give me the combo of all the different kinds of prices. So I can say buy grid dot times price grid, and see now I've got every combination, because see if I have one, this one 5 times, and 7 5 times, and 10 5 times, then I should have 15 possible options, right? There's 15 top possible prices depending on how much I buy and where I go. So those are the 15 different prices that I could expect to see. So Meshgrid is really, really cool because what it'll do is it will make two otherwise completely awkward and strange matrices that really don't belong together, and it will find a way for them to come together. It's like the peacemaker of functions and stuff. Now, where people usually go wrong is they'll just give it like one output, and they'll try to say by is equal to Meshgrid by stuff, price of stuff. And then what happens when they do that is they only get the first one. So I'm gonna take these out so they don't go in. Okay, so now look how I only got one of them. I didn't get the second one. So all I have is a 3x5. So I'm sorry, a 5x3. All I have is a 5x3. I don't have the other guy. So there's really not, well, depending on how you wanna look at it, not that much I can do with it. So, I know there's a way. You don't have to like comment, me. I know there's a way. I'm just trying to do it simply and straightforward. To me, it's like, why not do it the easy way? So rather than doing that one output, so I don't know if you want to make a note to yourself, but like, you know, don't do this. Don't do this. Okay. Do that. Because if you only get one output, then that's kind of defeating the purpose of Meshgrid. The way Meshgrid works the best is if you have two outputs, then you can multiply those two matrices in a way, and using element by element in a way that it actually makes sense.